Alright, this isn't my favorite hand in the world, but it'll do, I suppose. We have the combo in hand, so yeah, we'll keep it. Sure. It seems like every time I have the combo in hand, I've got the Sinjiri step in hand as well. Like, that's just been a running trait with me. And, I guess I should have actually started with a turn one Sinjiri step. Yeah, just running trait going on that I've, had the combo with the Sinjiri step in hand. It's not like that's a big statistic thing, it's just something that I've had the unfortunate about. So, I suppose we're gonna get Thought Seized. No, we're gonna get Search for tomorrow. It's gonna be like a dark Scape Shift. Oh man. How do I undo my last draw? There's gotta be a better way to do it. Let's see, undo last draw, there we go. Because the shortcut keys don't work now that I'm doing screen recording. I don't know why, but they don't. Yeah, we'll just drop this. Don't wanna rush into the combo, especially since Knight's not gonna be protected by if it gets bolted or anything. I guess it could get Abrupt Decayed since it is black. This also could be not Scape Shift, it could be well, there's gonna go my combo. Oh well. It's probably actually a like Death Cloud deck. I'm gonna assume my Knight is hitting the bin. And that's understandable. I guess it was giving me a look because I didn't actually have a way to cast that blue, but I do in a second. Real question is, do I want to put... No, it makes no difference in terms of a damage output whether I put the Quasali Pride Mage or the Noble Hierarch out. The only difference then is... in terms of... mana output. So... Yeah. It'll be better just to do it this way, so that way I can then have retreat mana to cast. I'm gonna guess it's a Deathrock deck, although it still very well could be like just a Scape Shift deck that's black. Those do exist, they're rare to see. Let's see here. Luxon Smiter is a pretty cool draw. We have 4 mana in total, so we can't do everything. We can do a couple things. I don't want to cast the retreat until I feel it's necessary. A 4/4 is bigger than Tarmogoyf's 3/4 body anyways. And it gets me more damage to go this route. So I'm going to do it this way. If he wants to take the damage, you know, I'm absolutely fine with that as well. The funny thing is, I can potentially get Thought Seized again or something, and then, like, if this was a land, I could just get Thought Seized and be pretty okay here with oh, excuse me, I'm just trying to think. Let's just tap one of those guys down. We'll swing for 5. He's got a block, right? No, he's gonna go to 3. I guess he might have Kitchen Finks or something in hand. But yeah, no. If he decides to, like, Liliana and then discard, and then I've got to get to put that one of Luxon Smiter out into play. I doubt that's gonna happen, though. Sure, Sakura Tribuilder. Collected Company seems like a perfect thing to do at end of turn. I'll just go ahead and attack. It's no real huge deal. I'm assuming he's going to block sack. He's not been happy with his lands. Yeah, I guess he runs blue as well. Look at that. And I'll pass it. You know, if he's got the blue for a counterspell, he's going to need to do something next turn anyways, because I'm getting to the point where I can just keep attacking and he'll keep losing. And, like, eventually I'll draw a land and then tap something down and he'll lose quicker. And he, like, can sack this for a basic, and that's all he can really do. So, we'll collect the company. They got a counterspell? Can he remand it? Do we have another Elquiry? So cool, the discard actually relevant then. We get to then put Luxon Smiter into play. Since it was end of turn, that means he comes into play untapped. Yeah, I wish I... Well, this lets me tap things down. And... That's gonna be game. There's no way he can get around that. So, that was actually really, really good to show how well that that Retreat to Coralhelm can get the combo. I had the combo in hand, couldn't cast it, did eventually cast it, and then went for the combo a second time. Even though it got stopped, my value beatdown plan was way too strong. So, pretty good. How are we going to side against this? I think he's like a Jund deck. No, he's got to be like a Scape Shift deck. That's what I'm thinking. At any rate, he had some Thalias seemed like they'd be good here, as well as Aven Mind Sensors and Jermaka's Command. That's what I'm going to do. Until I know he's 100% Scape Shift and I start bringing in things like Meddling Mages and Negates, I don't know. That's where I'm going to stick with. He seems like he's got a lot of interaction. He could kill off a lot of stuff, so Retreat to Coralhelm, not the greatest thing in the world here. My bolts weren't really relevant either, so I think maybe my bolts come out. And, I suppose my Quasali Pride Mages come out as well. Got no real use for them. Should really be siding out my Scavenger Muses more, but he's got Tarmogoyfs, so I'd keep my Scavenger Muses in this time around. Let's go ahead and... Yeah, where is it? There we go. Mulligan, even though it's not really Mulligan. I always get some Jiri's Step in my opening hand. I don't know why, it's just a curse with me. But, no, I'll keep this hand. It's got two knights and a geis. And that two knights are gonna beat the living crap out of him. It's just weird that my geis was dying to, like, bolts and Kolaghan commands. That doesn't normally happen here. Start out with this. I mean, it's nice to hold this sometimes. Sometimes you want to sandbag it. But right now, I want to be able to cast two drops. I'm going to guess a knight is going to leave, but it might be a geist that leaves instead. Anyway, I'm going to use this. Aired Misa next time. Geists. Multiple Geist. Tarmogoyf. Cool. Happy draw with that. I'm not going to get Blood Mooned by this guy. There's just absolutely no way he's got a Blood Moon to use against me. Let's see. I have out white, so I want to grab green. I'm going to play that Tarmogoyf that's now very big. We can follow it up with Knights, so we're doing pretty alright, I'd think. Sure, Tarmogoyf is himself. That's perfectly fine. I am going to go ahead and put down Windswept Heath. He doesn't know some of the stuff that I drew, so I'm just going to go attack and see if he just takes the damage. Nope. If he wants to bolt it after, I'll feel kind of upset, but that's fine. I'm going to go for a basic. It's going to be a forest that I grab, because I can grab a hollowed fountain with my Windswept, and that'll complete my land base that I need. But I want green in case I get a scavenging ooze. And I want a green in case I get scavenging ooze. And guys, and knight by itself is gonna be enough to block for a while. This guy's got Tarmogoyfs on Tarmogoyfs, but that's fine. This is a Tarmogoyf battle. I got a Tarmogoyf 2. Got another Tarmogoyf. Abrupt Decay. Sure. So he can swing for 3 if he really wants to. Not, or 4, excuse me. It's actually fine if he does that. I can swing back. Now the real question is, do I just want a Collected Company? Collected Company, in essence, gives me more value. I think I'd rather just Collected Company. I'll even just do it right now. Again, leaving my Windswept Heath for later. Yeah, this will give me more value. Now the question is, what do I want to grab? I think I want to grab a Geist, and I want to grab a Luxon Smiter. And I did that on my turn, by the way, so that way, if I missed and I grabbed Mana Dorks instead, my Mana Dorks at least would let me win Geif Wars. Geif Wars. Geif. But this puts me ahead in terms of card advantage. I've got several creatures on the board. I'm equal to him in mana, and I have equal amounts of cards, but I'm, like, ahead in board-wise. Fire Spout, huh? Alright, well that trades one for one, and then I lose my Geist, so that's fine too. Alright, so we're actually doing pretty alright here. I know it doesn't seem like it, but we can now cast Knight and Tarmogoyf, and swing for 4, and our life total is pretty well protected. That was actually a pretty desperate play on his end. And our yeah, it's going to be a 4-4 for now. So he drew a land. That's not super great for him, unless he has like a Thragtusk in hand. He's got another Tarmogoyf, and that's peachy. Let's see. Well, we actually have the combo here now. So I'm just going to say we probably win. Now, to think about this, the combo is going to cost us a fair amount of mana. And I'm not sure it's actually what I would rather do, to be honest with you. I think I'd rather just tap things down and attack. See, if I just... Because the combo is going to cost me at least 5 life. But, you know, I guess that's safe right now. He's got nothing in hand. It's going to cost me 5 life to combo out completely. But, yeah, that's probably enough. I won't do a full combo, but I'll do just enough to squeak by here. And I won't shortcut it either. So what do we got in hand? Oh, he's just gonna concede. It wasn't necessarily the game, but yeah, we would have had enough to just tap stuff down and then wolf run for the finish of the game. Because he was at 15, right? 17? 15? Yeah, we had that. We were doing fine there. We could have just comboed out. So yeah, the combo just took that situation, which was like a pretty alright stalemate. I think I had that just in a couple turns in the future. Although, if he drew any removal after his turn, it would have made it hard for me to win, just because he'd start winning with the, his Goyfs that were still out. So, I'm very happy with just winning with that combo. This was a really good game. So, this is, like, literally the next game, and, we got the combo as well. Again, it's not the God Hand combo, but it's pretty close. Do this, it'll get us serves a Hollowed Fountain. And then we'll move right along into actually getting off the combo unless he were to Thought Seize us right now. If he were to Bolt us, it's pretty bad too. It's just like, seeing Blood Admire tap is just never a good thing for me. Although Stomping Ground is a better use for it, I suppose. Monastery Swift Spear. Alright. That is gonna get pathed. And let's see here, what do I can do with this? I wanted to get the blue. Shit. I guess I'm just going to have to take the one damage. We're just going to path this Monastery Swift Spear. I think that's the best option. We're taking two damage off of our land, but yeah, he's just going to pump Monastery Swift Spear, and we're not going to be able to hit it with Geis, or with Tarmogoyf. Realistically, I should have started off on the Sacred Foundry. Plains is a good thing to do. Unless I actually want to just go for Stomping Ground into Tarmogoyf. Let's go for the combo. We're still high enough on life. And if he bolts it, you know what? No big deal. That's a bolt that went to my creature instead of my face. And there goes my Nether Rookery. That's fine and dandy. I mean, look, I'd rather have my Nether Rookery go down than my face go down. If it ends up being that he's like a zoo deck or a suicide zoo deck, I still made the right call. Because I gotta protect my life total as much as humanly possible. Rift Bolt, sure. Is rifted. So we're just gonna do classic value plan here with our stuffs. We're gonna go for the Luxodon Smiter, and the next turn we're gonna go for a Tarmogoyf and the Retreat. As long as my life total stays pretty floated above, I'm doing pretty fine. Retreat will also let me tap things like Death's Shadow. If he has like a Death's Shadow and he's like that Suicide Zooer deck. If he opts to kill my Luxodon Smiter again, that's more burn that's been pointed towards my Luxodon Smiter. Sure. He's got to point more burn as well to it. see what he's got here. 3 mana. Sure. So let's go ahead and retreat to Coralhelm, so that way when we drop this, even though it's going to hurt me, it's going to hurt me less to do it this way. Plus, I want to sandbag that if I can. Pride Mage. Do I want Pride Mage? No, I'd rather have, like, a way to combo out or, like, a better card that will win me the game. Like a removal spell would be good, too. Let's see what goes down. Edelon the Great Rebel, sure. So, kind of wish I left that Pride Mage on top, then. We'll just start attacking straight through. The difference here is with Retreat to Coralhelm out, I can actually tap down that Edelon for very cheap, or anything that's attacking for very cheap, and if he casts anything, he actually takes damage off of it too, so I'm actually very high up in the race. Just like with this Arid Mesa in hand, I can do the same deal. He's just gonna go to second main phase, not gonna even attack. Alright, cool. Sure, so I just won't cast things. That seems fine with me. Put this into play and tap one down, and then I will lose one life to a fetch land, which I'd rather not do, but I'm okay with, to then put in a, not even a basic, I don't even need a basic. Temple Garden seems great. And the only fetchable lands in my deck now are a forest anyways, just to keep that in mind. So this guy is not even a good version of it. I should have kept track of that, but whatever. Tap that guy down. So I'm going to be able to swing here, bring him down to 6. If he were to cast anything, it would kill him, I think, right? Because he would lose 4 life, and he would be at 2. So he'd need to be able to cast something, and attack. Because doing 4 damage to me is not enough. And if he attacks, then he's open for me to just counterattack. And also to drop this land and tap down an Edelon and just win the game off of it. Normally, Edelon is like death at this point for me, but with Retreat to Coralhelm, it's not. That's great. Yeah, he's at this point where he casted Edelon, and this I've been in this place too, where you think your only out is to cast Edelon and hope that, like, you can mess your opponent up, puts the pressure on your opponent. But the flip end of Edelon is it is a double-edged sword. Is that way, now he's realizing he can't cast literally anything and survive. There's just no way he can do it. And he's he can't attack and survive either. He's got to leave his Edelons up to, he's got to leave his Edelons up. And he can't cast anything. And that's fine. That means I'm going to win this waiting game now. Because I can take some damage. I'll just wait for a bolt or something, you know? Or another land, and I'll just sandbag this one in my hand. And I'll just wait. Because right now, he's Or like even a Wolf Run. I mean, I'm just in a better spot than him, so I'm willing to wait out this game. Because literally, he can't, like, cast anything. If he casts something, I win on a crackback. So my outs right now are Bolt. My outs are... Kessick Wolf Run is my real out, like my best out. I can also get let's see here, I can't do it that way, I've gotta right click and then go undo last draw, there we go. Scavenge News could be an out as well. Let's see here, I got no creatures in his yard. I've got two creatures in my yard. That'll half pay for the life damage that I'm going to use up for this. And it gives me a 4/4. No, it's not quite enough. It's just a waiting game that I'm very willing to play. Any kind of spell that he's going to play will damage him. And me leaving this Tarmogoyf, there's no way that he can do enough damage to me. And with this land in hand, I can tap down anything he were to cast to be blockers. Oh, Jesus. My mouse. Knight, I think, is a valid thing to cast. Because I do 4 damage to myself to do that, and I drop down to 6. And he still can't bolt me to death. Yeah, I think Knight was a good out. One, two. So Knight is above the threshold of being burned easily. And it also means that I can then, I don't necessarily need to, I'm not going to combo out with this. I'm just going to go for the value plan. I'm just going to actually get Kessick Wolf Run and kill him. Yep, alright, there you go. Game conceded. So game one against Burn. I've weirdly been doing pretty good against them. So we have all this stuff to bring in against Burn, like a ton. 10 cards that I can bring in against Burn? That's nuts. So what do we take out? Well, we take out things like Retreat to Coralhelm. We're never going to pull it off. That's not worth it anymore. We're going to take out things like Geists, because they block, I guess, sometimes. But they get blocked. We're going to take out Luxon Smiter. He's no good. We're even going to take out the Knight of the Relquaries, because they're all right in the matchup, but not super great. All the stuff that's my lower end stuff, like Core Firewalker, they're all better. Question is, do we keep a hand that is Tarmogoyf, Tarmogoyf, Tarmogoyf? That blocks a lot of creatures, but no, we're actually going to take a Mulligan. Meddling Mage and Core Firewalker are all way better cards to have in the opener, so I'm going to keep that. We're going to keep Core Firewalker on the top. That means we're going for Core Firewalker, Core Firewalker. We even get the lovely ability to crack this on our first turn, so we're only going to take 1 damage from it. Sure, Rift Bolt. I don't mind taking the Rift Bolt. It's perfectly fine. When I start doing Core Firewalker after Core Firewalker, and then, like, even Meddling Mage to protect my Core Firewalkers from, like, a Tarkus Command, no problem with that. Let's see, Temple Garden is probably what we want to grab. Yeah, we want to grab Temple Garden. Alright, Thalia's kind of cute. But, no, we want to rush this Core Firewalker out there since we got a Core Firewalker to back it up as well. So, here we go. Plains. Core Firewalker. Yeah, just like all these hate bears in my hand, there's absolutely no way I'm losing this. Like I said, when you side in 10 cards, you're very likely going to at least find one of them. Self-inflicted wound. Alright, I lose 2 life. That was cute, man. Go for another Core Firewalker. You got 2 self-inflicted wounds, you're down to 3 cards. It's not super great. I'm at 13 life. Alright, bump through the night. Look at that, you're getting there, you're getting there. Let's go with Meddling Mage, and we're going to name Self-Inflicted Wound. And if he decides to go to burn me out, that's fine. I gain a life off of it. And he loses a spell. Suppose Thalia could have been a better put out there, arguably. 2 cards in hand though. Let's not attack. We got nothing to put back in there yet. If he puts out a land, then I'm not going to put Thalia out. Sure, Riftbolt. Now I am going to put Thalia out. I mean, if you burn her now, it's fine. I just gain a life. And next turn, I'm going to be able to start casting things like Tarmogoyf. And then I'll be able to beat down. Like, if you were to cast Goblin Guide here, I'd be okay with it. No Goblin Guide. Some Jiri Step, huh? Alright, well, we're gonna put out the Tarmogoyf here. It's time for us to start being able to beat down. Red. Start swinging. You'd have to cast a creature and, you'd either double burn spell my Tarmogoyf or he's going to lose the game there. Another thing I could have done is I could have casted Noctel and then just left up path mana. That's probably the next play's turn. Maybe he's looking for like a Skullcrack or something. I'm really not going to let him have the time to do that, though. 3 mana, what would I rather do? Probably cast Pride Mage, because then I can at least kill off an Edelon for pretty much free. Yep, GG. So, there you go. Burn pretty easily. Beaten. A lot of hate that you can use. So there's that.